We were alone. sit. First, we honor the Lord, the great God of the universe. The Bible declares there is none like unto him, for he alone is worthy. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, he is worthy to be praised. They say angels bow before him. Y'all quiet in here. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. I know we're gathering on what some would call a sad occasion, but I came to celebrate somebody's life. We quiet in here. So listen, when you needed a song, God sent the gift to sing to you. When you needed a father, God graced you with a mighty man of God. Y'all quiet in here. So if we come for nothing else, we come to celebrate Jesus for the gift he lent to us, for the gift he lent to us. The time may have been shorter than we expected, but we still give God praise. Y'all quiet. We still give God praise for the gift. For the gift. Come on, y'all gave somebody something. They didn't quite say thank you. So just come tell God thank you for the gift. Thank you for the gift. For every tear he cried, God, we thank you. For every seed he sowed into your life, God, we thank you. For every word he said to you when you needed it, God, we thank you. God, we thank you. We thank you. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. He blessed us with an angel, and we thank him for the angel's presence in our lives, for every word he said, for every step he took, for every hand that he played in our lives, every bit that he did for us. We thank God for the gift, for the gift, for the gift, for the gift. All right, we're going to pray. Everybody stand it if you can. We're going to pray. We're going to approach the throne, and then I'll get out your way. All right, bow your head. Oh, precious Father, we come just giving you worship and honor because you are good. You are good. You are good tonight. This is our esteem of you, God. This is our declaration, is that you're good. There is no other God like our God. Come on, talk to him. You are God in heaven. God, you are God in earth. And we thank you, God, for gracing us with your presence. We thank you, God, for being God of the river. We thank you for being God of the fire, God. We thank you for being God over the flood, God over the mountain, over every storm in our life, God. Anything, God, that comes against us in our life, God, you have given it access, God. We thank you for being God of our trials, God of our tribulation. But most of all, God, we thank you. You have not abdicated your throne as sovereign, God. We appreciate you, God, because it's because of your perfect plan. We thank you, God, for being God of our situations, God of our circumstances. That anything, God, we need, we can access through you, God. If we need help, God, we can access it through you. If we need comfort, God, we access it through you. And God, we ask you to grant us in this time peace, God. Peace in our hearts, God. So we have resolve with your will, God. So we accept that, God, you are having your way, God. Though we may feel different, we thank you for your having your perfect will in our lives. We ask this and all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen. Amen. Amen.
We're glad you're here. And he know that you love. And just by showing your presence makes it even more special. Today I'm speaking about a man about love. If I can take a few minutes, because this is personal, and I believe y'all heard that before from him. This is our story. We met celebrating the life of someone we both love, and from death came the Jones of love. They say out of all the love stories, ours is my favorite. I would take it a step further and say ours is the best, weathering any test. All of the plans we had made to ride out this thing called life, passport living, five-star romancing, singing and dancing our way through any phase. We were made to love each other in a most amazing way. Even though you're gone, our story will always live on. Memories we made to stay, you will always linger in my heart and my thoughts. We were already one each day. Nothing can change the love we share, even after 18 years. It's also rare, the lasting of 18 years of a life that we best shared for 18 years. The last 18 years of your life were the best 18 years of mine. To be loved so completely, reaching the highest height and protected so securely by your heart. March 25th, 2004, through March 25th, 2022. Exactly. This was an 18-year novel of love that can never be replaced. Your memories will live on in my heart with my tears, smile, vivid daydreams each and every day. I love you beyond the word, and this is life. I know you love me the same. Echoes of a love story like that will always remain the same. Love, Lise.
Today,
give God praise. My children constructed the program. And Steve, if you don't know this, you think he's Cecil B. DeMille. And I don't know if you remember the Commandment movie. Okay, so when that was done, Steve just knew the Ten Commandments. Yes, thank you, Dr. Janae. So here today, I want all of you all to go back in your heads, all of the House of God family, which is Steve's blood family. Can you get on your feet? Can you stand on your feet just now so everybody can see all of Steve's blood family, who is the House of God, the Holy Church of the Living God, the pillar and the ground of the truth. We want to recognize Bishop Rawlins, my Lady Rawlins. These are our ancestors now. My mother, elect Lady Edistine Burno. My father, Bishop James Burno. Steve's father, Bishop A.W. Morrison, and his mother, Lady Naomi Morrison. We also want to recognize our singers of that time. Okay, we had my brother, which I love, and I wanted his sister Julia, but Lady Julia's song. I must tell Jesus. And I should love to hear her sing. And I wish that I could sing like her. But I can't sing like the Morrisons. And I can't sing like Lady Madison. But if Steve was here today, Steve would come out, he don't get up too often, and he would sing, I woke up this morning. Woke up this morning. I woke up this morning.
gonna tell you something. Bishop David, we living in a colossal tentacle of the devil. What are y'all playing? We all stop playing because we getting ready to go into World War III. I'm gonna take this mic to him, but I feel God in here. And the armies are coming from the east. They got Russia, they already invaded Ukraine. And Daniel told us in Daniel chapter 7 and Revelation chapter 17 and said that the whole world was drunk out of the wrath of her fornication and had drunk upon the testicles. While the city is, that's the house of God key there. What I want to tell the church, that you got to get yourself together. You got to get your praise on. You got to get a relationship with God. Not worrying about nobody else. But you ought to tell your neighbor. Say, oh, neighbor. Say, you ought to get God. Get your neighbor by the head. Break them and shake them. Shake them and rock them. Rock them and shake them. And say, hold on. You want to tell someone, say, hold on. Hold on! After a while! 1, 2, 3, go! Y'all don't want that. I'm gonna sit down because I said what I want to say. Glad to see you, Bishop. But Steve used to tell me when we was young in the church, and you know, we come from a dancing, I see you cutting. We come from a dancing church. I taught my babies how to dance. And Steve used to say, I can't dance. He used to say, I can't dance. Pam like that, she know what I'm talking about. You know, he was a philosophical. And 45 years ago, when he got the Holy Ghost, he used to go. Oh, 45 years ago. But I want everybody to stand up. We can dance now, but we
me to sing. I was not prepared. Amen. dedicate this song to my family, the Marsons. We've been through a lot in the past 2 or 3 years. We've been through a lot. So yeah, I'm going to sing. I'm going to get out your way. Amen. Pray for me. Lord, I will lift mine eyes to the hills, knowing my help is coming.
Up above my head, I hear music in the air. Up above my head, there's a melody so bright and fair I can hear when I'm all alone, even in those times when I feel all hope is gone. Up above my head, I hear joy bells ringing. Up above my head, I hear angels singing. There must be a God somewhere.
Come help me tell. Hallelujah to our God.
Yeah. Back to the hospital. When he got there, it was over. That was around about 7 o'clock. And 12 hours later, 7 o'clock, Saturday morning, sister, me and my daughter was here. And the one thing that I was so grateful for in watching them work do their magic, and I just want to take 1 minute to thank Aunt Betty. If you don't know her, she worked all week with my children to make sure things were in order. Amen. And the one thing that I love is every time we thought about anything, they said, what could Daddy do? They really didn't have to ask me or anyone else because Daddy had it all written out. And I am so grateful because it's one thing to have a man in your life, but it's another thing to have a man of God in your life. And according to the scriptures said God, and if you ever had a hug from Steve, you felt that thing. How many of you ever had that hug? Okay? Steve was big on giving out love, and he loved me, he loved you, and he always loved everybody that came into his presence. This is such an opportunity, a pleasure, and an experience to be able to stand here today and say he was one of the best fathers, husbands, partner that one could ever ask for. And I am so grateful today that as I present my daughter, his firstborn, he has been there from the beginning to the end. Even though he never got up to give her that bow, I laid there and tried to nudge him. He said, tonight is the night. And he never got up. But in 41 years, he has been an excellent father. I present to you now, Dr. Dene Morrison.
So close to my mouth, like that. I know. Did you wipe this off, Amy? Did you wipe this off? Thank you. Oh man, this is beautiful. First, I just want to thank you all for being here. All of the support, the love, the singing, the dancing, I love it. But my uncle just said it, my dad was philosophical. And so yes, he couldn't dance without. But he could lay down some scriptures and explain some ish to you like nobody else. So we're gonna do this in the spirit of the philosophy. I'm gonna give y'all a presentation. Thank you. Next slide. So that's my daddy, right? Next, there we go. In the middle? Okay. So my father, as I said, has always been a seeker and holder of knowledge. Today, I've worn my academic regalia, which is the graduation robe for the doctoral degree. I know my dad would have wanted me to wear this hot robe. But it meant so much to him, probably more than it meant to me. And so I wanted to wear this today to acknowledge my father as a brilliant thinker, and to thank him for passing this on to me and my brother, to his grandson, my nephew, but also for sharing his brilliance with all of you and all of those who knew him. Next slide, please. So my dad, nicknames are a big part of the Morrison family. And I think he said this at Uncle Ray's service, I believe. And so, my dad gave everybody a nickname. So you all knew my father. He had his own nicknames, okay? Yes, so y'all knew him as Steve, Stevie, Stevie Monkey, Uncle Weege, right? Granddad, Big Daddy Moo Moo, Pops, and so many other names. And so again, he gave out his own nicknames, and I had my fair share. I was Puddin' for a long time, then I guess I grew up. I became Jeannie Beanie, Genius Beanius, Baby Jesus, and a whole bunch of other ones. And my brother was Oh My Bucky. He was Brute for a while, but Daddy didn't give you that name, but he did call you that. And now he's known as Chef, but Daddy didn't give you that one either. That's all right. Next slide. So now I know there are some of you here who was gifted a nickname by my dad. So if you could just shout out your nickname. We're going to start out with Jazz first. What was your nickname, Jazz?
Mama Jazz.
Mama Jazz. And Jazz Melda. That's my favorite. But I know there's some other ones out here in the audience that got some. Just go on and shout it out. I see you, Tay.
He called my son Baby Barry Gordon.
For that deep voice, Baby Barry Gordon. Who else out there? Ed Skivaletsky. Yes, that's a classic. Ed Skivaletsky. Yes, go ahead.
Kimmy
Wimmy. Yes, go ahead. Angie Pangy. Q. Josie Wosey. Yes. Yes. Oh, I see some people. Yes, go ahead.
Jasmine
Taz.
My name is Sharon, and he always says,
Sure, I love it. Yes, and I know there's countless others, those that are online. We honor you and your nickname. So even with all of the nicknames, Mama Shelly Welly. Next slide. Oh, Liavolus, but I gave him that. Daddy didn't give him that name. Oh, Liavolus Malavolus. There you go. Dedrick Smedrick. Now, are y'all making up stuff? Oh, all right. So even with all of these nicknames, to me, he was simply Daddy. I was the first one to make him a father, and I just take pride in that because me and my dad were really, really, really close. Next slide. We had a special bond through our love of knowledge, music, food, sports, and above all, family. So I'll say a little bit about each of those. We could talk for hours, me and my dad, analyzing life. Or he would explain some off-the-wall stuff like the James Webb Space Telescope. I had no idea what he was talking about. But he explained it to me. I was like, oh, let me look that up. And next time I was ready for him, he asked me. Whatever it was that he talked about, though, we loved our ideas. We loved sharing our ideas and thinking anything. As far as music, while we were growing up, my dad listened to everything from the Hawkins family to Oscar Peterson. And that really just expanded our love for all kinds of musical expression. So, of course, the church was the foundation for that. But now, our Spotify records are off the chain. And food, you already know how my dad felt about food. How my family feels about food. But right now, it's about my dad. And I feel like as he got older, I think he learned a few things from my mom. And he actually became a really good cook. Yes, those oxtails, that lemon ginger cheesecake. Yes, child. And I'm going to just say, just since you just brought that up, Mr. James, who cuts the grass for my father, he boo-hooed. I told him, he said, oh, Steve, I can cut the grass. Left a message. I called him. I told him my dad passed away. When he came, he actually did come and cut the grass. And he said, your father made me a cheesecake. I didn't even know that. And he just was crying and just really loved and respected my dad. But the food situation, you already know. So I don't got to say too much about that. Sports. Now, my dad was probably the biggest Eagles fan. I mean, come on, let's go Birds. He hasn't even lived in Philly. It's been over 20 years. And my dad still watched the Eagles every Sunday. And we talk football every Sunday, all year. Oh, the Eagles, they're going to be good this year. Super optimistic. I'm like, I don't know. And actually, this picture was taken in August of 2021. My dad came, stayed with me and my mom, and we went to the Eagles opening practice, and we had a ball. And actually, it was the first time at the link where the Eagles play. And so it just really touches my heart. Yeah, we had a ball. And then there's family. My dad loved his family. Not just his immediate family, but his extended family. And he was super dedicated to finding out more about our history, particularly through his mother and father's line. And so this is very bittersweet because he was so excited that the 1950 census was coming out. It just came out April 1st, a week after he passed away. And he wanted to find more info, particularly in this census, about his father's mother, Eunice Stevenson. So I know Monica, where are you? Yes, so I know Monica was his buddy on the Ancestry.com situation. So please, Monica, keep that going. And I'll be right there with you. I'll do the research with you as well. Next slide. So real quick, now I'm going to need a little bit more crowd participation. So I'm going to give y'all a few lines of a story about my dad. And when I say because, y'all just going to say, that's my daddy. So let's try it out a little bit. So when I was about 8 years old, we went out, my Berno cousins in Philly, went out skating. Outside with my Aunt Nita, my cousin Eddie right there, his mom. Outside running around, Nita said, you better stop running around, you're gonna fall in them shoes. 7 years old, they keep running. Fell, cracked my head open. It was crazy, but they took me to the hospital. My grandma finally came in her Cadillac, we piled in. Took me to the hospital. Somebody must have called my mom or my dad. And my dad came. He was the one who came and sat by me in the hospital when I had to get like 7 stitches in my head. He did that because that's my dad. Thank you. All on point. So when we had snowy days and wanted to go sledding or make a snowman, my mom bundled us up. But it was my dad who went outside and froze his behind off for hours. That's my dad. My dad was so good at teaching difficult concepts, not just to me and Chef, but to everybody. When we were kids, he would use the phrase, inappropriate diplopiate, to let us know that, hey, that's not cool and you shouldn't do that. And we loved it, and we understood him because that's my dad. I could talk to my dad about anything, and he always gave the best premier advice. So when I came to him with a personal or professional issue and I heard his deep, soothing voice, I knew everything was going to be okay. That's my dad. My dad naturally extended himself as a father figure. That was the last one. Hold your breath. My dad naturally extended himself as a father figure for others, beyond just my brother and I, to my first cousins on both sides, foster children, friends, and other members of our community. I'd like to acknowledge you all, those that are here and online, and say that we are forever connected through all the love, energy my dad has given us. Let us continue to honor that. So with that in mind, I'd like to call up my sister cousin, Jasmine Morrison. Yes, who also was very close to my dad. She would say a few words. Share with us.
Thank you, Boo. Yes, y'all should be up here walking with your shoes.
That's all right, huh? Represent.
Right. I named him Uncle Lee. Louise would call me 12 sometimes in the night, in the middle of the night, and we just talk about him. And every time I call him, when I needed to cry, when I needed anything, he was there for us, me and my sister Deja, when we lost our mother. And me not even calling 911 when we found her, I called him. And at the time at his job, he couldn't answer the phone, but he knew when I called him, something was wrong. And he was there, crying, talking. We did everything. We traveled. He'll call me, want to go somewhere? I'm like, yeah, where we going? And he'd say, I got everything. You just drive. I was like, oh, no problem, Steve. Even times when I call him, I'd be like, me? He'd be like, yo. I was like, what you doing? Nothing, sitting here watching National Geographic. I was like, that's him. And I was like, Uncle Steve, you want to watch a movie or something? You want to watch that? But that was him. Mama called him Webster. Because every time she needed an answer, you don't want to look it up. You just call Uncle Steve. He got everything. And not only that was my uncle, that was our dad. As well as Chef. Elder, you say you want me to see me cry, but I'm crying today. So I have a poem, and I will miss you always, Uncle. My heart has been left broken since the day you had to go, and the memories I treasure dearly are in the tears that flow. You're in my thoughts every day, and that's how it will always be, for you may be up in heaven now, but you'll always be with me. If only I could have the chance to see your face once more or hear your voice one final time. Just like it was before, the day that heaven calls for me would be a relief from all this pain. I will run to you with open arms and we will meet again.
I said, I've done, and it was all beautiful. First, just want to let everybody know how grateful I am. Through all of this sadness, you know, and sadness sometimes can be a selfish thing. But mostly I'm grateful, and I'm thankful for all of you guys showing your love. It speaks to the abundance of love that my Father has given. So to start this, my presentation off, which is about the endpoint of Stephen L. Morrison. First thing I'm going to do is stand up. First, I honor my mother, because through the mother comes all living things. Every single person in here came through the same exact gateway. There's only one. So if you didn't know, this is why we pulled the chair out for you. I know the new age mindset of women is, I can get my own chair. We know you can. We know you can pick up the trash. We know that you are capable of fighting for yourself. But what kind of man would I be if I didn't protect the only gateway into this dimension? So with a young woman, I want you to think about that the next time you go to wherever you at. And you hear someone talking about this, you may hear someone who's strong-minded say, I can pick up my own trash. But when we do that for you, it's not about that. And then you have to understand, you're not pulling out the chair for anything else but respect, right? And then taking hold of the place of who you are just as a human. Every animal protects the woman, right? So when a king has a kingdom and there's a battle, how can I send the women and children? Is this the end if I do that? But if the men go and some die, and all of them die, but I got some young men and I have the women, we still can go forward. Today, they having a cloud that makes you think that's unfair. That's total respect. There's no disrespect in that. We know women can fight. You can shoot a gun. You can do everything that we can do. But it's out of respect. So first, I just want to respect the beginning. And I want to move on to, I asked a couple questions to myself whenever I speak. I told my son this, the trick to speaking is asking questions. You don't have to write down the answers if you just write the questions. It'll automatically jog your head, so it's my secret. And I asked myself, what did my dad mean to me? It was Pops. Pops. All my friends call him Pops. All my friends call him Pops because he was a father to all of us. To many people. He also became my friend, my best friend. My best friend in the whole world. And it's a beautiful thing. I had 20 years. 2 decades, just me, my dad, and now my son, and being able to exchange and upload 3 generations of data is a beautiful thing as well. So that's why I feel an abundance of appreciation. What he taught? Well, you heard the first thing, honor the women. He came to me the other day. I don't know if this is TMI, but I was taking a shower and just crying in the shower, no less. And my dad came. He looked at me like that picture, that exact one with them squinty eyes. And along with him, my Uncle Ray. Tina came. a lot of energy to digest, so work with me. And I felt down Tina's hand grab my shoulder and said, you know what to do? He squinted at me with those eyes. And I hold on to Ray, say, support the family. To reinforce the family and honor your mothers. To reinforce the family and honor your mother. Said it three times. And they went away. They left. It was amazing. It was sad. But the armor that they gave me was fulfilling and allowed me to stand here strong on 2 feet. And just repeat that message to everyone. Now, my dad was a timely person. We tried to keep that going, but I think we about be a little bit over. Just a little bit, a couple minutes. A couple things that he used to say is, number one, trust in the process. So we trusted in the process. The process that we trusted in that he taught me about took us a little bit over the time. That wasn't my plan to say that, but it just connected, which speaks to trusting in the process. Right here. When he passed, my brother here, also my cousin, he sent the word. Oh, y'all got it. I didn't call him, man. He sent word. He didn't call my exact phone. He sent word through, and it came around. That's cover. Another good friend of my dad's, KK, back. Where you at? Somewhere in here. I can't see you. You here? There you go. Hit us up. We have another space for you where we're going after this. Cover. No problem. I wanted to do something with my cousins and my family that was close. I thought about it. I even sent a text about it. Immediately, another good brother, Big John, he called me, said, hey, the studio, the whole spot is yours. We didn't ask anything. What we did do is trust in the process. My son's mother is sitting there. We've had you can stand up because it's Liao's part to honor you, but I'm going to stab in real quick because this is perfect. She's the mother of my child. It's all due respect every time, all the time. But we've had our ups and downs. We done went through it. And the whole time my dad would say, see if y'all learned it something. Second thing he used to say is to use les tantes, which is a French word. My dad spoke French. He taught us a lot of French words and attached messages to them. And it helped them stick. It really did. Les tantes. What is that? The relaxation of strained relations or tension. As between nations. I'm a hothead. I've probably been through that. Been working on it for 39 years. Still working on it. But you got to trust the process. And in the process, I learned how to use their time. Right? Misdirection is another way you can put it. It seems like it doesn't fit, but it actually does work. Sometimes you got to say one thing just to take the attention off of that other thing. That's what the secret really is about. Because your attention draws in. So sometimes you have to use their time in a lot of different ways. But also with an argument. With human beings. We're human. We have feelings. We have emotions. Through this time of dealing with everything we needed with my father, we had plenty of tension. I don't think we're just a perfect family. We're just like everybody else. But through that tension, we had to figure out how to use some their time. Next thing he taught me is God is love. Love is God. God is love. Love is God. So whenever I do things, that is the, those are the rules that I've been living by. Like my cousin Chelsea said, I'm still trying to get there, but I will. Last part, the last thing he used to tell me is to use a scientific approach. As it says there, didn't read it on the bottom, demand evidence and think critically. This is my dad. If you knew him, you know that he has a scientific mind. Trusted the scientific process. Sometimes religion says, oh, I don't need no science. I ain't too much for that science, that book learning. But the thing is, spirituality, religion, all things use that process. You use it every day. When you got up this morning, yesterday, the day that you thought about what you was going to wear, you use data to calculate and formulate the most plausible truth, which is how good you might look. Scientific process is just a matter of questioning, thinking critically, and trusting the process. That's another extra part. But we talked about a lot of things using that process. We talked long, long, long hours about all types of stuff, black holes. On the edge of outer rim of a black hole, you're actually alive and dead at the same time. This, let your mind think about that possibility. It's a fact. That's actually a very interesting topic. But these are the crazy things my dad, Stephen L. Morrison, liked to talk about. You know, a lot of my friends are here, my brothers. Y'all can stand up, please. For a moment. My dad was a father to many. He was Pops. And we loved him for it. When we go over to the Vibes in just a minute, we'll have food and we're going to have some words coming from a lot of the family. I want to have them to speak. These are my brothers, and my dad was Pops. Long live Pops. Yes, yes. So now that brings me to the end of my presentation. When we go over to the other place, you're going to hear some other people speak. But the end point is actually my son. Now, there was one more part to my notes. I'm looking at my notes. Hold on right here for a second while I say this last part. My dad also was a friend. He was a friend to many. He had a full of wisdom. And I have my Amex crew. Stand up, please, y'all. I see a whole lot of y'all. Big family. These people showed a whole lot of love to my dad, and to me, they are a family. Over 2 decades of knowing you all, and I appreciate you all dearly for being here. Particularly, Miss Keisha and Cookie, they were like sisters to my dad. Y'all two stand up. In particular, Cookie's in the back, and Keisha right there. So many different things that they both have helped me with personally outside of my father, and it speaks to the love that he gave. I love you, Becky. I just wanted to make sure I honor you guys because I love and respect you just like auntie, just like sisters, just like family, because you are family. You meant a lot to my dad. Any of nights you guys talk, I walk in. Yeah, of course I'm nosy. My daddy. That one, daddy. And They're also going to share with us when we go over to the Vibes. So everybody do come after this. Get you some food and hear some memories. So I'm going to turn it over to my son. For a moment, he's going to speak about the actual endpoint, because he is that. He is the next Stephen L. Morrison. Yes, son, take it away.
A lot of things to me. He was the man who always had the answers. The man to calm me down and look at the bigger picture in life. Granddad was the wise owl of my life. I remember when me and Granddad used to watch horses on YouTube when I was little. Him in his big leather chair and me in his bed. As I got older, he taught me about wars, watched movies about Vikings, Spartans, taught me about how to look through other people's eyes, taught me about cultures, taught me about just teaching me the world, how the world is, and why is that way. My favorite memory of Granddad, every day after a football game, or any game, track, football, showing him my highlights, and looking at his face and seeing how I made him smile, seeing how proud of me he was. So therefore, I want to do everything in the best that I can to make him proud. Thank you, God.
Another good friend of mine, another brother, to take us on home. Brother J. Rev, on up here. After this, guys, please follow us over to the Vibes Lounge. That is his favorite place. We're going to jam. We have kungas, shakers. This is something that we talked about years ago. And we're going to enjoy it. The way that my dad like to do. If anybody know my dad, they know before it's time to party, what he do? Oh! And you be like, it is time to party. So we're going to do what my dad loves to do, and that's enjoy and celebrate through music. And take us home, boy.
So Mama Omi said that Uncle Wiggy's favorite song was this.
Woke up one morning. I woke up one morning.
Come on, y'all, come on.
I woke up one morning. I woke up one morning.
Come on. The enemy gets confused. So let's give him up a praise real quick.
He's done for me. You don't know what kind.